And welcome back, everybody, as we look back at the past week in the Stephen Avery murder trial. Manitowoc County Detective Dave Remaker also testified on Wednesday. Now, he said that Lieutenant Link assigned him to head up the Manitowoc County end of the investigation into Teresa Halbach's disappearance. Remaker said he and Lieutenant Link interviewed Avery at his home the morning after Halbach was reported missing.
I think my comments were, I think Calumet County is barking up the wrong tree. I think we both were in agreement at the time that Steve had nothing to do with it. That was just our feeling.
Now, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Well, he was a prosecution witness at the time.
Well, it's obvious that Ken Kratz is trying to use that testimony to combat this tunnel vision theory that the defense is trying to put forward.
Right, right.
So they're saying, you know, that this, there's no way that they just honed in on Stephen Avery. Not only did they maybe think someone else was involved, they didn't even think Mr. Avery was involved. So that's obviously to combat that part of the defense, and it depends. If the jury finds Detective Remaker to be credible, mm-hmm. then that's good evidence for the state.
All right, good insight. Hey, on the second day of the search, Remaker said he found a voice message from Teresa Halbach on Barb Yanda's home machine. Remaker said the message was left on Halloween before noon. Stephen Avery called Auto Trader magazine that morning using the name B. Yanda to request Halbach so she could photograph the van his sister was selling.
Hello, this is Teresa with Auto Trader magazine. I'm the photographer, and I'm just giving a call to let you know that I could come out there today. In the afternoon, it would probably be around 2 o'clock or even a little later. If you could please give me a call back and let me know if that'll work for you, because I don't have your address or anything.
Now, Ken Kratz defended playing that voicemail because he said it was helping set up the whole timeline for things. What do you think about that?
I think it's undisputed that Teresa Halbach was there at that property. So in a way, this could be considered cumulative evidence and they don't even need it. But, you know, Ken Kratz done a good job. He got it in, and now he can make his argument that these people are hearing from Teresa Halbach, like he said in his opening, mm-hmm. that, you know, Teresa Halbach's going to tell you who did this. You're going to hear from her, and he set that up well.
An emotional tug as well.
Absolutely emotional.
All right. On a Thursday, Calumet County Deputy Dan Kaharski told jurors about seeing Sergeant Colburn and Lieutenant Link the day Teresa Halbach's RAV4 key was found in Stephen Avery's bedroom. Now, the defense says Colburn and Link planted that key. Special Prosecutor Ken Kratz asked Kaharski whether the key could have been planted.
Yes, I guess it is possible.
And is that in the sense of anything's possible?
That's in the sense of it's possible aliens put it there, I guess.
Right. You were not watching Link and Colburn to be sure that they did not plant evidence, right?
That's correct.
Back to that key, he said it could have been possible.
And I think that's actually some typical police speak, because that's how sometimes the police come off at a trial to say, yeah, it's possible, but, you know, that it's so far remote. But I think that this actually helps the defense, because I think that looks somewhat unprofessional on behalf of the police officer. And they've already established that someone should be watching these Manitowoc officers. Now there's Mr. Kuharski, and he's not watching. Mm-hmm. That's a perfect plays right into the defense's argument.
All right. The state arson investigator.